Hi friends, I am Amar Mohite. Our today's topic of discussion is volumetric apparatus or laboratory glassware. Volumetric apparatus is an integral requirement for quantitative estimation done in laboratory. The accuracy and precision of results is greatly dependent upon the use and selection of appropriate volumetric apparatus for analysis. The volumetric apparatus are made up of borosilicate glass. Why borosilicate glass is used for making the volumetric apparatus? Because borosilicate glass is resistant to thermal shocks and chemical attacks. Borosilicate glass can sustain different temperatures and it is inert with respect to different chemicals. Borosilicate glass does not interfere chemically during the analysis. Hence, borosilicate glass is used for making the volumetric apparatus. Friends, there are two class of volumetric apparatus, class A and class B. Unless otherwise specified in individual monograph or your specification, preferably class A glassware shall be used for analysis. Class A glassware are recommended for the analysis which requires highest accuracy and precision. Class A glassware comes along with calibration certificate bearing the unique serial number or traceability. Also, Class A glassware does not require further in-house calibration before putting them into routine use. You can use directly Class A glassware for your analysis without further calibration in laboratory. The tolerance limits for Class A glassware should comply with the standards mentioned by NIST, that is National Institute for Standard and Technology, and ASTM E694. It means that the tolerance limit for Class A glassware should comply as per NIST and ASTM 694. What is ASTM? ASTM stands for American Society for Testing and Materials. These tolerance limits for Class A glassware are mentioned in USP General Chapter 31. The tolerance limits for volumetric flask, transfer pipettes and burettes are mentioned in USP Chapter 31. For example, we have taken the tolerance limit for volumetric flask from USP 31. This is the table for volumetric flask. The first row contains different size of volumetric flask. Second row contains the tolerance limit in ml, and the third row contains tolerance limit in percentage. For example, for 10 ml volumetric flask, the tolerance limit for class A volumetric 10 ml flask is plus minus 0.02 ml. If you convert 0.02 ml in percentage, the tolerance limit will be 0.20%. Similarly, for 25 ml volumetric flask, the tolerance limit in ml is plus minus 0.03 ml, and if you convert this limit from ml to percentage, it will be 0.12%. For 1000 ml, the tolerance limit in ml is plus minus 0.3 ml, and in percentage, it will be 0.03 ml. From this table, you can see that as the size of volumetric flux increases, accordingly the tolerance limit in ml also increases. However, the tolerance limit with respect to percentage gradually decreases as size of the volumetric flux increases. The second type of volumetric apparatus is class B. Class B volumetric apparatus are not recommended for quantitative analysis. These apparatus are generally recommended for less accurate work. These apparatus generally used in schools and colleges for demonstration purposes. Class B apparatus require in-house calibration before putting them into use. The plastic apparatus, for example, generally in IC analysis, that is ion exchange chromatography, sometimes when your eluent or mobile phase is highly basic, that is alkaline, in that case normally plastic apparatus are recommended to use, because at higher pH there are possibility of leaching of glass. This leaching of glass may interfere in your analysis. Hence, where highly alkaline mobile phases are there, the plastic glasswares are recommended. These plastic glasswares should comply the tolerance limit given for class B apparatus. The selection of correct volumetric apparatus is critical step in any quantitative analysis. For example, a burette to be used for analysis should be of such size that the titrant volume should represents more than 30% of the nominal capacity of the burette. If your expected burette reading is 15 ml, in that case you cannot use the burette of 50 ml size, because 30% of the 50 ml is around 17 ml. Since 15 ml is less than 30% of the nominal capacity of 50 ml, you cannot use burette of 50 ml for quantitative analysis. If your expected burette reading is less than 10 ml, in that case it is mandatory to use the burette of 10 ml or a micro burette of 10 ml. You cannot use the burette of 25 ml or 50 ml. It is mentioned in USP 31. It is the requirement of USP General Chapter 31. The glassware calibrations are generally done at temperature between 20 to 25 degrees Celsius. Hence, it is recommended to minimize the volumetric error that the volumetric apparatus used for analysis, the material to be analyzed, the solvents and diluents to be used for analysis, and the environment, that is laboratory, should be maintained between 20 to 25 degrees Celsius to get more accurate results. The glassware or volumetric apparatus should be dried at or below 60 degrees Celsius, because at higher temperature there is a tendency of glass to expand itself. Hence, it is recommended to dry your glassware at or below 60 degrees Celsius, because at higher temperatures, due to expansion of glass, there are chances of disturbing your calibrations of volumetric apparatuses. Whenever you transfer the sample from transfer or measuring pipettes, it is recommended to transfer the sample vertically in vertical positions at the center of volumetric flasks, and final draw of the sample should be touched at the wall of receiving vessel, that is volumetric flask or beaker. The cleaning of glassware is very important step to get the accurate results and avoid the contamination. Hence, it is the responsibility of each organization to have a procedure in place for the cleaning of glassware. The procedure should contain at least the mechanism for the washing of volumetric apparatus, the name and concentrations of the detergents to be used for the washing, and the respective persons involved in washing of the glassware shall be trained on the cleaning procedure. It is also recommended to validate your cleaning procedure of glassware with appropriate methodology. For example, either by chemical analysis, by using chromatographic technique, or by using TOC technique. So these are some requirements related to the volumetric apparatus. We will make a different video on how to validate your cleaning procedure of glassware. So friends, volumetric apparatus are very, very important asset for getting the accurate results. That's why in this session we have discussed the general requirements and handling practices during the analysis. So friends, this was all about the volumetric apparatus. If you have liked the content of this video, please subscribe my channel. Thank you very much.